Cyber stacking is the use of the internet or other electronic means to stack, stalk, or harass an individual. So if somebody is using the internet, okay, or any other kind of electronic mean to harass or stalk any individual, then it is going to be called as cyber stacking. It may include false accusations, monitoring somebody's movement and life, then identity threats, solicitation for sex, or gathering information that may be caused the threatened or harassed. So anything on the internet, if anybody does, which can accusations or make some accuse something, or it is a mean for monitoring somebody, or if it is trying to trap the identity or giving threats, any kind of threat it can be. Threat can be life threat, it can be a financial loss threat, or it can be some threat for, you can say, loss of public face. Okay, so the threat can be anything. It is a reputation loss. It is, that is also a threat. Okay, then solicitation of sex, or gather information of other and about others, all comes under cyber stalking. So here you can see cyber doxing, trolling, cyber bullying, hate speech, public shaming, intimidation or threats, all these things comes under cyber stalking. Okay. So who are the most likely victim and offenders of cyber stalking? Anyone can be victim of cyber stalking. However, females are more likely to become victimized than males. An educational institute are also a very likely target for cyber stalking. Here you can see slide on cyber bullying. Cyber bullying is another way of threatening or harassing people. So you can see if people are giving a harsh comment or some unsolicited comments to somebody, all these things comes under cyber bullying. Yeah. Even you see that these comments are not directly offensive or something, but these comments are something which can put somebody or feel somebody harassed. Okay, then cyber stalking, if you see the gender of victims, then 13% of males are usually, as per survey, are victim of cyber stalking, and 87% of females are used to be victim of cyber stalking. You see the age group of victims, as per survey, 41 and over are only 19%, but if you see this 18 to 30, this age group, 54% of the people are going to be victimized. Okay, sorry, 54% of the total victim are in this age group, and 27% of the victims are age group of 31 to 40. So what does this stalking occurs? It can occur through email, news group, or message boards, like it can be WhatsApp group or any chat group. Then internet websites, today social media. Chat rooms, then third-party instant messages and service user profile. So all these things are way of where the cyber stalking occurs. So by email, what kind of cyber stalking occurs? People can send threatening mail, some alarming mail, or anything of harassing nature. Mail. Okay. If you think about our message board, the offender post threatening statements that are directed towards specific group of people or an individual. So when people are posting something threatening, or you know, it is something can cause harass of somebody's sentiment or you know, view, opinion, all these things are comes under this. Then internet site like offender can post very alarming and threatening comments on a website like Twitter and all. Okay, and then website that contains defamatory, personal, and degrading things about person. Then chat rooms send threatening materials directly to the victim in real time, and anyone else in the chat room is allowed to view it. Okay, so then it is comes under cyber stalking. Third party instant messenger software that tracks when the victim logs onto a messenger, like you know, previously when WhatsApp came, that time people was able to see if you have somebody's contact saved on your phone, and you was able to see that at the what time last that person was logged in. And still now you can see that who is online. Okay, so this is another way of stalking over somebody else. Okay, and then proceed to harass and harass the victim in the real time. Even nowadays WhatsApp has option to disable this option so that other can't see whether you are online or not. And then service user profiles are other things. Now, how does harassment begin? 1% of the harassment begins in option and offline. 3% are by virus or personal ad. Then 8% are through websites, news group, message boards are 9%, instant messages are 12%. Chat 15%, and in email you can see the highest, which is 39%. Then what is the reasons of cyber stalking? It can be due to jealousy, it can be obsession on something or somebody, it can be due to attraction, and it can be to take revenge. So some cases are here, interesting cases are here. This is one called Parth. Man charged with cyber stalking. 29 years old man in Armadale, Parth. Stalker sent naked pictures of the victim in the shower. So that stalker has simply captured some naked picture of the victim and sent to the victim in by some email or some mean. So threatening to post the photos on the internet if the police. Now, as a result, what happened? 128 charges was put on him, including unlawful insulting optical surveillance equipment, then indecently dealing with a child and stalking. So these are main charges, but like this, total 128 charges was imposed on that stalker. Another case is University of Illinois ex-boyfriend cyber stalking over lover. So you can see that person, this boyfriend, had named himself as a hacker ex. So what he had done, tampering and stalking ex-girlfriend online, stealing identities and altering password, threatening her with physical harm. Okay, so all these are the unlawful acts he had done. As a result, 20-year sentence in jail was awarded to that person. So you can understand how I can say how severe is this, and as per law, and what can be the consequence of doing cyber stalking. That is a very important information to know. Now, effect of harassment. What happens if somebody is harassing somebody else on the internet? What effects can come? Chances of sleeping and eating pattern, nightmares, anxiety, helplessness, fear for safety, and shock and disbelief. Okay, so all these are the, you know, as a outcome or things happens to the victim. Then, this is to prevent cyber stalking. Tips to prevent cyber stalking. Never reveal your home address on the website. You know, many of the people used to reveal their home address or resident address on social websites. This is something to be avoided. Then, password protect all account. Conduct an internet search using your name and phone number so that you can find that whether there is some profile, a fake profile on your name on different social media website or not. Be suspicious of any incoming email, telephone calls or texts that ask you for your identifying information. Okay. Then, never give out your social security number, or like in our case, Aadhaar. If you are living a partner, a spouse, or boyfriend or girlfriend, reset every single password on all of your accounts to something they cannot guess. Okay, so it is very important. If you think you are a target, have your PC checked by a professional. So if you think sometimes that somebody is monitoring you or trying to track your activities, then it's better, always better to check the PC by some professional. Or even, you know, if you have enough money,